Hi guys and welcome to my new video. In this video I will demonstrate the use of parameters. For this I will be designing my version of the Connect 4 game. You have probably come across such a design in a short form video. The game pieces are vortex shaped, which gives a cool effect when playing. To get a clear idea what I will be doing in Fusion, I start with an old school sketch first. I am using OneNote here, but basically everything from a piece of paper to a tablet is probably fine. I start with a side view, that is, from the player's perspective. There will be a lower part where the game pieces will be kept. In the upper part there will be openings. These should be arranged in a regular grid, so the distances should be the same horizontally and vertically. I name this parameter grid size. This pattern will go in both directions, obviously. I denote the number of columns as n calls, which will be 7, and the number of rows as n rows, which will be 6. Now I want to name the main dimensions of this view. I denote the overall width as total width. The overall height will be divided into upper height and lower height. Now let's turn to the front view. In the bottom there will be a container for keeping the game pieces. The overall depth of this base part should be equal to upper height. This way the upper part will fit perfectly on this bottom part. Also, I want to have a parameter for the wall thickness of this container. I name it standard wall. Now I think about the height of the container. The pieces cannot be larger than grid size, obviously. To make them really safely fit into the container, I make the inside of the container 10% taller than grid size. Now I think about the pieces themselves. They must be grid size in height, as they should stack according to the grid. They must be thinner than the total thickness of the upper part. Here I want to use a smaller wall thickness than in the bottom part, as the vortex geometry will provide increased strength anyways. I call this thickness min wall and add the parameter upper thickness for clarity. Now I sketch the pieces in the front view. The columns should also be separated from each other by min wall. On the sides I want to have some extra space, as there will be some snap fit structure. I name this extra width width sides. Now let's do a quick sketch for this interlocking part. There will be some protrusion in the bottom part, which will fit in the recess of the upper part. Aside from this area though, there should be a clearance between all the sliding parts. Only in the protruding area will there be no clearance. I name the interference between the two components when sliding in snap interference. I have finished my sketch and now I will switch to Fusion. The first thing I want to do here is to enter the parameters I've just decided to use and assign some values. I select Change Parameters from the Modify menu and add my user parameters. While I define the first few parameters, feel free to like and subscribe and join my free community to ask your questions, link in the description. I also enjoy reading feedback or ideas for new videos in the comments. I've chosen a fairly small value for grid size and the standard values for row and column count. With these I had to take care to choose no units as unit. Standard wall will be 1.6 mm, min wall will be 0.8 mm and the width for the side structure should be 4 mm. I choose a clearance of 0.2 mm, which is fine for the Bamboo Labs X1E printer I will be using for this project. Note that I would recommend a larger value for most other, more standard printers. For now I choose a snap interference of 0.3 mm. The good thing about using parameters is that it will be very easy to change all these values after finishing the design. In the end I will give you an update based on my prints. Now let's define some more parameters. Only these will depend on other parameters. Let's start with upper height, which will be n rows times grid size. I continue with the lower height parameter. It will be grid size times 1.1 plus the standard wall thickness. The upper thickness will be grid size plus min wall. This is not so obvious to see, but follows from the fact that the piece diameter will be grid size minus min wall, and the upper thickness must be 2 min walls greater than the piece diameter. I probably should have introduced a parameter for the piece diameter, as we will see later on. Now I calculate the total width. It is the sum of all the column widths, so n calls times grid size with an added min var and 2 times the side width. Now that I have finally done all the parameter work, I can start with the actual design. The design will be mostly symmetric in the front as well as the right plane, so I will only do a quarter of the whole thing first. I start with a sketch on the right plane and sketch half of the lower part, which will be merely a rectangle of width total width by 2 and height lower height. I then extrude this rectangle for upper height by 2. I decided to add a large chamfer to the bottom part, so I choose lower height by 2 as chamfer length. Then I shell the body and enter standard wall as thickness. Now I want to make a structure that closes off the upper part and separates the two players' sides. I make a sketch on the front plane. Here I again use the parameter standard wall for the wall thickness. I chose an overhang angle of 45 degrees. The upper part of this section should be upper thickness. Considering that I do only sketch one half of the bottom part, I use half the value of this parameter, just as before when I have used half the wall width for the center wall. I want to extrude this sketch all the way through the existing body. To achieve this, I select all as extent type and then set operation back to join. Then I quickly check the result before hitting OK. Now I continue with the snap fit latch and I create a new sketch on the outermost face of the body. After sketching the geometry, I set the base width, one standard wall thickness smaller than the upper width. The top width should be half that, so I simply use the base dimension as a parameter in the formula by just clicking it instead of entering a formula. I set the outer angle to 45 degrees and have already fully constrained the sketch. Now I extrude the profile for a distance of width sides. As I want to reuse this ledge to hold the upper part in place in the closed position, I select a new body option. To facilitate assembly, I add a chamfer, which is half the width of the side body. Then I create the sketch on the center face of this body. I want a spherical snap face, so here I create an arc and an axis to rotate. Then I add a dimension for specifying the interference depth. I have to consider the clearance here, so the value is the sum of snap interference and clearance. After finishing the sketch, I rotate the profile accordingly. Here I joined the pre-existing bodies by mistake, so I went back, hit the initial body and reconfirmed the rotate to join the new feature with just the side body. Now I continue with the top part. I create the sketch on the back plane and create a rectangle. For now I just want to sketch the bottom half of this top body and later mirror it up. So the height of the rectangle is upper height by 2. Its width is upper thickness by 2, considering the overall symmetry again. I finish the sketch and extrude the profile as new body. I set the extent type to 2 object and choose a suitable face of the pre-existing body before hitting OK. So this body will be used in multiple locations. The upper part should be able to snap in with its bottom face. This is where the side body is placed right now. But it should also be able to snap in with its side face, so it covers the bottom container part. If you are not yet perfectly sure where I'm going with this, please bear with me for a minute, it will become very clear in a few steps. First, I join the body to the bottom body, but select the Keep Tools option to keep a copy. This bottom part is basically finished. Now I want to use this snap latch body 2 more times to cut cavities into the upper body. As there should be some clearance, I first offset the faces. After selecting all the contact faces except the sphere-shaped one, I enter the parameter clearance and hit OK. Next, I want to move this body to the correct upper position while keeping a copy at this original position. I choose Move Copy, select the side body, choose Point to Point, and check the Create Copy option. Now, this copy is kind of in the right place, but certainly not oriented correctly. So I repeat Move Copy, only this time I choose Rotate, select this edge and the correct angle of 90 degrees. I don't want to create another copy, so I uncheck this option before confirming. Now let's turn to mirroring. I mirror the upper side part down first. Then I have a look at all the bodies to confirm that I'm on the right track. I mirror the main upper body in the upwards direction. Then I can remove the side cavity body from this upper body. I quickly confirm that there now is clearance between the bodies as intended. Then I mirror the upper body towards the other player's side. Now finally I can remove the side cavity for the closed position. Also, I mirror the lower body towards the other player's side before mirroring everything one last time. I have created the fully parametrized bodies for my game and take a few seconds to confirm that everything looks fine. If you find my content helpful, feel free to like and subscribe. You can also directly support my work or join my free community, links in the description. Now I continue with the vortex style geometry. I start the sketch on the top plane. Based on a vertical auxiliary line from the origin, I add a construction circle. This will be the outer diameter of the vortex geometry, so I enter grid size minus min wall. Now I have to think about the distance of the first column from the origin. This will be half the distance from the first to the last column. The total distance is the number of columns minus 1 times the column distance. So for half that I enter n columns minus 1 by 2 times grid size. Next I start sketching one of the fins of the vortex. I start with a line from the center and a circle which is tangential to the larger circle. Then I add another line and an arc before constraining everything properly. Then I add some dimensions. As I want to have 6 of these fins and I have only sketched one half, I set this angle to 360 degrees by 6 by 2 equals 30 degrees. The smaller circle will be standard wall in diameter. Also, its distance to the symmetry line should be standard wall by 2, so that the minimum thickness of the vortex will be standard wall. Finally, I mirror the sketch before finishing. I need another simple sketch for the vortex, this time on the right plane. I project the center point of the vortex sketch and then add a vertical line. The length of this line will be the height of the upper part, which is grid size times n rows. This sketch is already finished. Now I can create the sweeping. Single path will work fine here. As profile I choose the vortex fin and as path I choose the line I've just created. Then I think about the twist angle. I have to enter the total twist angle here. I want every window for the pieces to exactly look the same and there are n rows pieces and every piece repeats 60 degrees. So the total angle must be a multiple of 60 degrees times n rows. I choose to go with 3 times this value, but other integer values would work too, as long as the overhangs don't get too bad. I confirm the sweeping. Now I create the circular pattern. This initial body should repeat 6 times around its center axis. As there is no join option, I have to join the resulting bodies after creating them. Then I make a copy of this body using the move copy command. I delete the move body from the timeline to keep it clean. By the way, I could have just selected the body and typed Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V instead. After hiding the original body, I choose offset face and select any of the body's side faces. I want to increase the size of the body by my chosen clearance value, so I enter the clearance parameter as distance. I quickly confirm that everything was offset as expected before continuing. Now I want to create the playing piece. I start with a sketch on the right plane and project the center point as before. I create the vertical axis from this point and sketch a rectangle of height grid size. For the diameter I made a mistake, it should have been grid size minus min more, just like before with the vortex profile. Then I add chamfers to the cross section of the pieces. I make them also depend on the parameter grid size, so everything will scale nicely. Then I finish the sketch. Now I revolve the profile I've just created around its axis. Then I fillet the edges. Again I make the radius depend on grid size. After that I recognized my mistake with the diameter and fixed it. I first had a look at the top sketch before fixing the diameter in the sketch for the revolve. Then I intersect the initial vortex with the revolute body. And I have finished my basic plane piece, however, I chose to add some more tiny fillets. My pieces will slide inside a channel shaped according to the offset vortex. So I removed this body from the top body. Every column will need its own channel, of course, so I add a rectangular pattern of this feature. I choose the y-axis before setting the quantity to n-cals and the distance to grid size, which of course applies to spacing instead of extent. For some reason, compute type adjust did not work properly, so I chose optimized instead. After some calculations, Fusion comes up with the result I am going for. What is left to do is to cut some windows for the plate pieces. I create an offset plane through the vortex center point before creating a sketch on it. I start with a vertical construction line from the origin again, before adding a horizontal axis and sketching around a triangle from there. The center line must be half the piece height from the origin. I choose the maximum diameter of the window to be 5% smaller than the piece height, so I enter grid size by 2 by 1.05 as radius. Then I specify the inner margin of this window, which again depends on grid size, and an overhang angle of 45 degrees. I finish the sketch. After showing the upper part of the game, I revolve the profile I've just created and remove the result from the body. Then I mirror this last feature towards the other player's side. Finally, I create a rectangular pattern from these last two features. The axis will be the Y and the Z axis, and the distances will be grid size in each direction. The quantity will be n cals in the Y direction and n rows in the Z direction. Here, compute type adjust works fine, and after some time for processing, my game is finally finished. I quickly check from all sides before moving the bodies into separate components. Then I do a section analysis to confirm the inner workings of my design. What is particularly beneficial of my parametric design is that I can change the parameters and update my design without making any changes to any sketches. For example, before printing the whole thing, I want to make a minimal test print. I deactivate the automatic compute option before changing any parameters. This is important as changes would otherwise be propagated after every individual parameter change, and this would take way too much time with a reasonably complex model like this one. Then I change n rows and n cals to 2. After applying the parameter changes, I have my cute minimal example, which I print to confirm that everything works as expected in the physical product. I finally made some parameter changes you can see on the screen right now. My designs were printed on a Bambulab X1E, so keep in mind that many other printers may need significantly larger clearance values. I hope you've enjoyed this video and have learned something interesting or helpful. Again, feel free to like, subscribe and join, links in the description. I also love hearing from you in the comments. Have a great time designing and prototyping.